Today we have Opel Corsa B model with a 4-cylinder engine, 8 valves. I'm going to show you how to change the thermostat. First we have to drain the coolant. We are going to open this hose that goes to the coolant radiator. And we are going to drain the coolant. Open the hose, we are draining the coolant, and now we can start working for the thermostat. The thermostat is located in here, and the bad thing is we have to disassemble the timing belt so we can remove the thermostat. That's why first we are going to remove the air filter housing. We have removed the air filter housing. Now we can loosen the alternator with 13mm wrench. Remove the V-belt. We have removed the V-belt. Now we can remove the protective plastic here. There are 3 bolts with 10mm wrench. Now we have removed the protective cover for the timing belt, and we can see the timing belt is in good condition, it's been changed recently. That's why we are not going to disconnect on the, we are not going to open the coolant pump, because there it's adjusting, so not to have problems with the leaking at the coolant pump. We are going to open the center bolt here, and we are going to remove the sprocket. But first we have to remove the crankshaft pulley, and that's why we are going to press the vehicle to remove the crankshaft pulley. Now we have pressed the vehicle, we have to open the center bolt so we can remove the crankshaft pulley. I'm going to open with air tools. If you don't have air tool, you are going to have to remove this metal cover here with 4 bolts so we can lock the flywheel to open the crankshaft pulley. I'm using an air gun. That's why I'm not opening for there. We have removed the crankshaft pulley. Now we have to remove this 1, 2, 3. Here we have 4 bolts, 10mm wrench to remove the other protective plastic. This one is with the tensioner for the timing belt. It's better. We don't have to open the coolant pump. We are opening this with 13mm wrench, and we can remove the timing belt. Then we have to open this bolt here with Torx 30, and there is one here, and we have 2 at the top. Then we can remove the whole plastic for the timing belt, and we can remove the thermostat. We have removed the timing belt, now we can start removing the protective plastic. Also, we are going to remove this crankshaft pulley. We have to just pull it towards. Now we can lower the vehicle, and we can finish the work that is on top of the engine. Now we have lowered the vehicle, and we have to open the camshaft pulley, so we can remove the plastic. We are opening with 17mm wrench, and we have to hold it in this hole with a special tool. I have a homemade special tool that goes into this hole here, and I can open it, but I'm opening with air tool, that's why I'm not using it. Now we just have to open these 2 bolts that hold the plastic. Now we have removed the protective plastic. Now we can see the thermostat. There are two bolts, this one and this one, with 13 millimeter wrench. Now we are going to open them. Now we have opened the bolts, remove the housing. Now we can remove the thermostat. And as we can see, the thermostat is stuck open. That's why the car didn't reach 19 degrees Celsius. And here we have new thermostat, and you can see it's now we can install it. First we have to clean this area from the silicone. We have cleaned the area where the thermostat sits, and now we can put it inside. Now that the thermostat is in its place, we can install the cap and tighten the bolts. Now that the thermostat is fitted, we can return the protective plastic. We have installed the protective plastic. We can put the two bolts here, also the two bolts at the lower. Now we can return the camshaft and crankshaft pulleys. And now we have to place the tensioner, and then we can turn the crankshaft and camshaft to set the timing. Now we have set the timing on the crankshaft. Also we have set on the camshaft. Now we can install the timing belt. Now we have installed the timing belt. Now we can raise the vehicle and to adjust the tension. Now we have to adjust the tension on the coolant pump. This should be like this on this mark here. Now we have adjusted the coolant pump for the right tension. Now we have installed the protective plastic, 3 volts, 10 millimeter wrench, and we can install the crankshaft pulley. Now we can lower the vehicle to finish the work on top. Now we have installed the top plastic for the timing belt. Now we can install the V-belt for the alternator. Now we can return the air filter. We have returned the air filter. Now we have to return the hose for the coolant. Now we have installed everything filled with coolant. Now we can start the engine and let it to warm up. We are leaving the cap open until the thermostat opens. When it opens, we are going to refill with coolant, and we are finished.